So welcome, and thank you. Thank you for giving up your Sunday afternoon to join us. I know this isn't easy. I knew I was going to cry. We're all going to cry. And that makes it okay, right? We're a room full of people who get it. So again, thank you. I think one of the most significant aspects of this service is that you get to know each other and that you walk around the memorial tables and really get a feeling for not only individual losses, but this beautiful relationship that we have with our animals. That's really, I think, the heart of today's memorial, is getting to know each other as well as is to watch the slideshow that Wendy has put together for us here in a few minutes. Lastly, as you depart, we have Engelmann spruce saplings out there for you to take. We thought a living memorial might be an incredible way to celebrate your loved one. And there's directions on that, so nobody has to, no anxiety. There's directions on how to handle it. And again, I will talk a little bit about that after when we conclude the service. I want to spend a moment thanking all the sponsors for making today possible. The Argus Institute is a small but mighty group of four, maybe four and a half on certain days when people bring kittens or puppies for us to love. And we honestly could not do this service without the assistance of the following. So as I said, Fiona's Delicatessen and Catering provide the food. Home to Heaven sponsors us every year, and they have just been a godsend for us, no pun intended there. Precious Memories Pet Crematory and Cemetery, Precious Pals Cemetery at Rest Haven, Rainbow Bridge Pet Crematorium, and World by the Tail. All these precious friends, I'm going to say, help make this happen. So thank, and then most of them have representatives here today, so thank you all for that. I want to start with a reading. I typically cry during this, so just maybe if I say that out loud, I won't do it. We'll find out what happens. I think it's a pretty significant way to start out today. I share with you the agony of your grief. The anguish of your heart finds echo in my own. I know I cannot enter all that you feel, nor bear with you. The burden of your pain. I knew that, sorry. If I didn't do it, it wouldn't be real, right? I can but offer what my love does give, the strength of caring, the warmth of one who seeks to understand, the silent storm swept barrenness of, oh, so great a loss. This I do in quiet ways, that on your lonely path you may not walk alone. I would ask, especially those in the first five or six rows, to just look behind you for just a second, because those in the back can see us. Would you turn around just for a second? So we're not alone, are we? No. We have a room full of individuals who get it, who have deep relationships and have had deep relationships with their animals and their pets. And this is why you're here today. I think there's something very significant in meeting together as a group. It's validating, it's affirming that you're not alone. Oftentimes, in pet loss in particular, people feel that the loss is stigmatized, that others don't understand, that maybe they're very alone in their process because they don't feel comfortable talking about it, and that's not the case today, not the case at all today. So again, thank you for coming, thank you for caring for each other, and thank you for loving your pet and loving one another, and honestly, I think you'll find a whole lot of love in this room. My second reading is a charge to you. Grief is a wound that needs attention in order to heal. To work through and complete grief means to face our feelings openly and honestly, to express or release our feelings fully, and to tolerate and accept our feelings for however long it takes for the wound to heal. For most of us, that's a big order. Therefore, it takes courage, a lot of courage, guys, to grieve. It takes courage to feel our pain and to face the unfamiliar. It also takes courage to grieve in a society that mistakenly values restraint, where we risk the rejection of others by being open or different. Open mourners are a select group, willing to journey into pain and sorrow and anger in order to heal and recover. One of the participants that came today, Kelly, came up to me and said, "This is hard. It is very hard. It's hard to lose someone that we love so much. It's hard sometimes to come back to the hospital if you've not been here since the last time you lost your honey. We know that's hard. And it's hard to be in a room where there's so much emotion." So I just encourage you to think about how courageous you are for being here today and for loving so deeply, right? Because if we didn't love so deeply, we wouldn't hurt so deeply. So thank you.
I'm going to do a reading that's a poem by E.E. Cummings. It's called "I Carry Your Heart With Me." I just think it's really appropriate because we don't have our beloved animals with us, but we still have them in our hearts. I carry your heart with me. I carry it in my heart. I am never without it. Anywhere I go, you go, my dear. And whatever is done by only me is your doing, my darling. I fear no fate, for you are my fate, my sweet. I want no world, for beautiful, you are my world, my true. And it's you are whatever a moon has always meant, and whatever a sun will always sing is you. Here is the deepest secret nobody knows. Here is the root of the root, and the bud of the bud, and the sky of a tree called life, which grows higher than the soul can hope or mind can hide. And this is the wonder that's keeping the stars apart. I carry your heart. I carry it in my heart.
Thank you. having a hard time saying goodbye to you. I never thought that my heart could break in two. People say it's gonna take time and all of the strength I can find. Having a hard time saying goodbye to you. Saying goodbye, tears in my eyes. Saying goodbye, so hard to do. I never thought I'd be saying goodbye to you. I'm having a hard time letting the memories go. Days I wonder, where did the time all go? So many things I wanted to say. I never dreamed that I could hurt this way. Having a hard time letting the memories go. Saying goodbye. I'd be saying goodbye to you. I'd be saying goodbye to you. No, I never thought I'd be saying these words to you.
some life lessons that I feel like our animals have tried to teach me. And in talking to several of you, I feel like they have taught you some of these same lessons. Sometimes I think if these guys could just sit us humans down, they might say, could you walk away with four things? I just asked you to remember four things. Four lessons in life. I think they'd say, first, I'd love for you to learn to live in the moment. And I know as humans that we hear that a lot. It's easier to hear than it is to sometimes understand and to practice. But I know that they have tried so hard to teach us this lesson. I've seen them try to teach this lesson in everyday things, like the way they go for the walk. So sometimes they'll be on that trail of that scent, and they'll be going and going, and they don't care where they end up. They don't even care what they step in on their way to get there. Other times, they'll enjoy that walk so much that it will seriously take an hour to get from the house to the mailbox. I think another way that they show us to live in the moment is the way they take their naps. I'll see them spread out in the sunshine in the middle of the floor, or in the middle of the kitchen floor, and they'll be sound asleep without any awareness of the complete chaos around them. They're just in the moment, enjoying their nap. Oh, and I have absolutely witnessed them try to teach us this lesson in the way they endure their hardships. And I know a lot of these guys endured some hardships. You know, they never dwell on how they got to their situation. They never complain. They truly just live in the moment. And that's a lesson I try to take from them every day. That's my first lesson. I think their second lesson would be to trust our instincts. And again, I think as humans, we might say, yeah, not so sure we have instincts anymore. And I think they would ask us to just not think about things so much and do what feels right. Again, I've seen them trying to teach this lesson to us. Like when they get up in the morning, they just stretch and it feels so good. They don't have to put it on their calendar to remind them, and they don't have to go to the gym. I see them trust their instincts when someone they love comes home. They stop everything they're doing and they just come over and greet you. And I see them trust their instincts when someone is having a hard day or is a little bit sad. And you know they know to just come over and be near you in your presence. They don't try to solve your problem. They just come and be near you. They're trusting their instincts. I think the third lesson that they would like to teach us is to celebrate every day. And so many of these photos showed us how they love to celebrate every day. And each of you can picture the happiness and the things that made your pets happy. I think they try to teach us this lesson in everyday things, like in the way they enjoy their meal. And it's the same food day after day after day after day after day after day after day. I think they show us how to celebrate every day in the way that they work for us and in the way they compete for us. And I think their fourth lesson, if these guys could sit us down today, would be to love with an open heart. And we are all here today because we have loved and we have been loved with an open heart. And for those four lessons and so many more, then thanks, guys.
I'm going to read a reading called Meditation. May you find the strength to mourn with dignity. May you find the strength to mourn in peace. May you find the strength to mourn without shame and embarrassment. May you find the strength to mourn fully so that your heart will be healed. May you find the strength to mourn out loud and cry until your crying is done. May you find the strength to understand others when they must face a similar road. May you find the strength to mourn with patience and to be tolerant of your own need to move through this at your own pace. May you find the strength to accept that you are mourning and to be at peace with that while your heart mends. May you know that mourning is good for your heart. It cleanses your heart and renews your inner being. May the memories of your beloved animal comfort you so that you can be ready to love again.
In the rising of the sun and in its going down,
we remember them.
In the blowing of the wind, and in the chill of winter,
may we remember them.
In the opening of buds and the rebirth of spring,
may we remember them.
In the blueness of the sky and in the warmth of summer,
may we remember them.
In the rustling of leaves and in the beauty of autumn,
may we remember them.
And in the beginning of the year and when it ends,
may we remember them.
When we are weary and in need of strength,
may we remember them.
When we are lost and sick at heart,
may we remember them.
When we have joys we yearn to share,
may we remember them.
So as long as we live, they too shall live, for they are now a part of us as we remember them.